The instrument diagnostic test of your Metrum DS2500 analyzer failed. What to do? I'm Nicholas Rühl, and today I want to show you what to do in such a case. A successful instrument diagnostic test guarantees that the system delivers highly reproducible and reliable results. Your DS2500 analyzer instrument diagnostic test includes two main tests, a hardware test and a performance test. Each test comprises multiple tests, such as a lamp test, a noise test, a wavelength precision and accuracy test, and a bandwidth test. In the regulated environment, it is necessary to perform an instrument diagnostic test every week. For the non-regulated environments, we recommend to perform an instrument diagnostic test on a monthly basis. You can do this using either the internal standards or with certified external standards as required by USP. When the diagnostic test fails, the first step is to recalibrate the instrument. For the instrument calibration, select the corresponding button under Tools in Vision Air. Enter your PIN code and choose between the use of an internal or external wavelength filter. Only external wavelength filters are certified. For the DS2500 solid analyzer, you also need the corresponding DS2500 holder and the NIRS reflection standards. The NIRS transmission wavelength standard is required for the external instrument calibration of the DS2500 liquid analyzer. For more information, read chapters 339 and 3310 in the Vision Air local tutorial. You can find the tutorial on our website with the document number 8105-8032. If the instrument calibration is not successful, a broken lamp could be the reason. To learn how to replace the lamp of your DS2500 analyzer, watch our video, How to replace the lamp in a NIRS DS2500 analyzer from Metrum. If the instrument diagnostic test still fails, contact your local Metrum specialist. Thanks for watching.